أفلا يتدبرون القرآن؟
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We're still with the third verse in Surah Al-Fatiha, الرحمن الرحيم. Two names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the attribute of mercy. And with the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the perfect names and attributes. No deficiencies in the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing is the like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the all-hearer, the all-seer. Human beings, they have mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in the hearts of the human beings, and they need to develop this mercy. And to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with regarding to this mercy, to have mercy towards one another. And this mercy is nothing compared to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing is the like of Him. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said in the authentic hadith, and this is a hadith Qudsi, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that His rahmah surpasses or come before His anger. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry with the disbelievers, and in the Day of Judgment, this is mentioned in many of the evidences in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, that the hellfire is the place where the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is served. And this is basically the perfection of the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the mercy comes first, as it's mentioned in the hadith at Qudsi. The believers, when they depart from this earth, they depart from the agonies of this earth, this life, and the pain that a person would go through throughout his whole entire life, to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned in the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, that when people die, either they would have a form of relaxation, if it's correct to say that, they would transfer to the state of comfort, and other people will be in state of comfort as a result of them departing from the face of earth. The believers, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said that he will be saved from the agonies of this life to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine the meaning of this. And if we ponder over this meaning, that a person is departing from this life to where? For the believers, to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is so vast. And that's why, as it's mentioned in some of the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that the believers won't want to come back to the face of earth after they depart from this life, except only the martyrs. They would wish to come back for what reason? For them to fight in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that they are martyred, so that they would receive this great honor as a result of being martyrs for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when it comes to the disbelievers, people are saved by the death of the disbeliever when he dies. Why? Because the presence of the disbeliever brings the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the less virtue and the less benefit that a person would get as a result of the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is also, and again, there are many evidences in the Quran or in the Sunnah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام that shows the effect and the signs of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you would see in the Quran, in some of the verses of the Quran, it mentions the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the creation of Allah, in the creation of the night and the day and the sun and the moon, and the different things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides for us. And you would see also in the Quran and in the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam that the religious meanings, the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is by itself a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we would see that, for example, that the Quran is a mercy from Allah. And we need to witness this. We need to deal with the Quran, that this is the mercy that has been revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Because how can a person subject themselves to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without getting to know the Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا. That means that it's by the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His mercy, they should rejoice. That brings the happiness in the life of a Muslim, that when we witness the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned the authentic hadith that a man among the people of the children of Israel, when he killed 99 human beings, and he wanted to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sincere repentance. And he went and he asked a worshipper, someone that is a monk, for example, and he's worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he thought that he has knowledge, and he went to ask him, would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept my repentance if I repent to Him? He said, no, He won't accept your repentance. So he killed him. So they become 100 now. And then he was told that there is a scholar, a knowledgeable person, go and ask him if you have a chance for repentance. So he went and asked him and he chose the virtues of the people of knowledge. The person of knowledge told him, yes, who can deprive you from the repentance and from the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you need to go and travel to so and so village, because in this village or in this town, there are righteous people, those who are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you need to be with them. You need to have the company of those who are righteous to help you to be steadfast in your state of repentance. So as a result of that, he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he traveled, and on the way, the angel of death came to him to take his soul. And the angels, they were of two groups. The angels of mercy, they wanted to take his soul because he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the angels of punishment, they wanted to take his soul, meaning that he will be punished as a result of the crimes that he committed, such as a severe crime. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent an angel, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, but it's for us to learn from this, and for this to be witnessed for or against the human being. He sent an angel as a judge between them, and he told them, measure the distance between the town that he left, his town, and the town that he is wanted to reach. If he's closer to the town that he was in, then the angels of punishment will take his soul. If he's closer to the town that is having the righteous people, then the angels of mercy will take his soul. And when they measured it, in one of the narrations of the hadith, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the earth then shortened, in which he was made closer to the town of the righteous people. And as a result, the angels of mercy, they took his soul. It was mentioned in the hadith in one of the narrations, like in Sunan al-Imam al-Tirmidhi rahimahullah, that this person, while he was dying, كَانَ يَنُوءُ بِصَدْرِهِ, which means he was trying to get closer to that righteous town with his chest, although that won't benefit him. Won't benefit him whatsoever. Why? Because he's dying. What's the movement of his chest to go forward would do for him? But it shows the truthfulness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made in his heart. It shows the vast mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his creation. Also, the Prophet ﷺ, he taught us to have mercy even to animals, and there are examples of this. The Prophet ﷺ said in the authentic hadith that a woman, she entered the hellfire because of a cat. The small creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was the reason for a woman, a human being, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth, for this human being to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How much the human being is honored, but still this woman entered the hellfire as a result of what? As a result of abusing a small creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is hirra, a small cat, as the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned in the authentic hadith. Also the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and this is in Sunan Abi Dawood, that a camel complained to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is from the miracles of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. A camel complained to him that his owner tied him up, and he complained to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, as a result of that, he spoke to this individual in some tough words to tell him to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with regarding to these animals. These animals do not have the ways to express themselves. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam told them that you should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with regarding to these animals. And it shows how the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to have such a mercy. This is something that you won't find in any place on the face of earth except in the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, perfect revelation. Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that we are ordered to show this mercy and to have this mercy in our hearts and in our actions towards the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam also ordered from the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As I mentioned before, the prophethood by itself is a mercy from Allah, so that the human beings are not left to be led astray, but instead they are ordered to follow the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the teachings of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the one that teaches people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, the one that teaches the people to be kind to one another, to be truthful, not to lie, and that he forbade anything and everything that is evil. You would find it all there, in the perfect way of life, in the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, to the extent of which, that he said alayhi salatu wasalam, man rahima ولو ذبيحة عصفور رحمه الله. This is an authentic hadith in صحيح الجامع عن الشيخ الألباني رحمه الله تعالى, authenticated it, which means whoever has a mercy to even the smallest thing that we're supposed to slaughter if we want to eat from it, like a bird for example, if he has mercy towards this thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy for such a person. To that extent, any form or any type of mercy that a person show to any of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the result is given from the same sort of deed that a person would do, and that is he would receive the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many ahadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that a person would enter Jannah if he has three of his offsprings, they die when he was alive, and even two as it's mentioned in some of the narrations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would make such a person, and for women, that she would enter the Jannah as a result of the mercy that she had in her heart towards her children. So when a mother has that mercy in her heart towards her children, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward her for that. So nothing is wasted actually in our life. When a mother is taking care of her children, when the child, for example, is sick, and you would find this feel of mercy that would be present in the heart towards the young child, this feel of mercy, the person is getting rewards for it. And that is by itself the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which directs us basically to seek this mercy and to have this mercy towards one another, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before that ordered. And this was something very clear in the lives of the Prophet ﷺ and the companions radiallahu anhum. You would see in the stories and the biographies of the companions radiallahu anhum, like Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, Umar, Uthman, Ali, the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, and the many incidences that has been reported to show and to for us to see how much mercy they had towards one another. For example, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, after he became the Khalifa, the leader of the Muslims, after the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he used to, before that, he used to milk some of the goats for some of the poor people. And this is the humbleness that they used to have, radiallahu anhum. And this was before he became the Khalifa. This was at the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. He would go to the poor people and some of the widows and so on, and he would milk their goats for them. And after he became the Khalifa, some of these widows and some of these poor people, they said, now Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he won't do the same. Why? Because he's now the leader of the Muslims, the head of the state of the Muslims. How would he come to our homes now and milk our goats? He was doing this for the sake of Allah. He was rich, as we know from the history of the Prophet ﷺ, that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he had his own trade and he was a rich. He was rich among the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, but he would do this humble act for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. When Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu heard this from them, he said, no, by the name of Allah, by Allah, I would never quit such a deed. And he would still, radiallahu anhu, after being the head of the state of the Muslims, would still go to some of the poor people and milk their goats. And this is the examples and the effect of these companions radiallahu anhum reciting the book of Allah and living with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is what we need to develop. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam also said in the authentic hadith that the example, the parable of the believers towards one another when it comes to their mercy towards one another is like one body. If one organ of this body complains, then the rest will also complain with fever and pain. So the same thing, this ummah of the Prophet ﷺ is one ummah. And that's why what happens in the East or in the West, a Muslim have an effect in his heart when he hears about another believer being hurt or whatever there is, he feels that mercy in his heart. And this is something that is rewardable by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the verse, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most beneficent, the most merciful, something that should show clearly in our affairs, in our lives, and while you are standing in the salah, witness this. And this is as the ulama, they say, so that we have the effect of Surah Al-Fatiha in our life. We talked about Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, that should bring, as we heard before, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He's the most perfect subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is the Rabb, He is the provider, He is the creator of the heavens and the earth and all that exists. And then Once you reached this verse, when you are in the salah, while you are in the salah, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, you have this hope for the mercy of Allah. You have this act of worship which is Ar-Raja. You hope for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do the good deed, then you hope for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the rewards from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala while you are reciting this beautiful verse, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. And also we would think, how can we develop this feeling in our hearts? How can we have mercy towards others when we call them to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This religion is a religion of mercy. For a person to be saved from the hellfire, we need to put things in the proper perspective. Mercy is not just in eating and drinking and having a pleasant life. The real mercy is when a person enters the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the benefit of a person living his whole entire life in some form of luxury, but then once a person dies, he entered the hellfire? Where is the mercy then? The real mercy is when a person receives it in this life to be obedient to Allah, to be steadfast on the deen of Islam, to be saved from the hellfire. And this is our mission. Our message as Muslims is to convey this message of mercy to mankind, to save themselves from the hellfire by doing what? By worshipping the one that created them, by turning to him alone, by following the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. And this basically should be the effect in our lives when it comes to reading and reciting the Quran and pondering over these verses of the Quran. If we go through the creation of Allah, the things that we see, the things that we do not see, and we try to explain and to ponder over the effect of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all of these creation of Allah, that takes a long time. But this is enough for us to ponder over and to live our life according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us, that we subject ourselves to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll be right back after this break, inshallah.
أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ